चेयरमैन AICTE प्रोफेसर पुनिया जी, हमारे MS और सेक्रेटरी राजीव कुमार जी एंड ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स एंड कलीग्स एट AICTE एंड ऑल हु हैव जॉइंड दिस इनिशिएटिव और दिस टॉक फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कॉलेजेस institutions across the country. I welcome you all to this extremely delighting session, extremely different kind of a session, where we will be talking about how we can integrate innovation and Indian knowledge system. On multiple forums, during discussion, we get a lot of WhatsApp messages where it is talked a lot about how great our Indian culture is, how innovative our saints were, and then we pass it forward, share it with our people. There are a lot of good videos on YouTube which talks about the great work which our various saints have done, like Panini, Aryabhat, Pingal, Bharadwaj, and so on and so forth. These rishis have given us great knowledge. And many times an argument is there that whether we can prove this knowledge using modern scientific tools and methodologies. And considering this objective, our Honorable Minister for Education, Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal Ji Nishank, constituted a cell, an Indian Knowledge System cell at AICTE. Sri Shukla Ji recently joined this cell as head of this cell. And the cell will be focused on bridging the gap between our ancient knowledge and modern tools and modern knowledge and how it can be converged to create our new IP, to create new innovations, products which are relevant for this country and maybe for the world. As innovation cell, we are doing multiple initiatives. Recently, you have seen we launched Kapila Initiative, which is IP awareness and literacy initiative, which has received huge amount of traction. Yesterday, I was going through the data. Already, we have few lakh students and faculties joining this initiative. Few thousand students have actually taken the assessment which we had put out related to IP awareness and IP literacy. And the figures and the data which we are getting is really very, very encouraging. So I believe that this session where we are going to bridge the gap between Indian knowledge systems and innovation is going to be extremely innovative and unique for this country. And that's the reason I believe that this session and this journey forward is going to be extremely critical. And considering this value of this concept, we have our chairman personally joining this initiative, this talk, where he will be kickstarting this entire process, supported by our vice chairman and member secretary. And we believe this will help all our students and faculty realize the importance which Ministry of Education is associating with this initiative. So now I request our vice chairman, Pooja sir, to take this session forward and throw light on how we would like to build up this engagement and start this process across the country.
थैंक यू अभय जेरी जी, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका. एंड इट्स अ वेरी वेरी न्यू इनिशिएटिव जहाँ पे इंडियन नॉलेज सिस्टम और इनोवेशन आपस में हैंड होल्डिंग कर रहे हैं. एंड इट्स अ वंडरफुल इनिशिएटिव. अब AB शुक्ला साहब ने भी इसके लिए स्वीकृति दी, आदरणीय चेयरमैन साहब का भी टाइम हमें जो है मिला. भारतीय बच्चों का वो अपना ज्ञान है, आज के दिन का ज्ञान है और हमारा जो पुराना ज्ञान है, क्या इनको आपस में इंटीग्रेट कर सकते हैं और क्या देश की अर्थव्यवस्था के अंदर इसका एक बड़ी भागीदारी हो सकती है, और विशेष रूप से व्हाट एवर नॉलेज वी पीपल आर हैविंग टुडे एंड द नॉलेज विच वी हैड इन पास्ट, क्या रूरल डेवलपमेंट के लिए वो ज्ञान काम में आ सकता है? क्या एक बहुत बड़ी स्कीम भारत सरकार ने उन्नत भारत अभियान के नाम से चलाई हुई है, इंडियन नॉलेज सिस्टम की स्थापना AICTE में हुई है, we are having MHRD innovation cell which is now ministry of education innovation cell, so all sort of integration we are able to do now. Honorable chairman sir is with us. First of all sir, we would like to listen you in what way AICTE is going forward, and particularly for strengthening the students, the new education policy has come, new education policy is giving freedom to the students also, multidisciplinary activities, even connect to society, so lot of hopes society is having. And the initiative which we people have taken under your dynamic leadership, sir, would like to listen in what way this connect will be strengthened in time to come, and how confidence building of the students and our Indian knowledge system, how it can be integrated and how it can be converted into some livelihood of the society, how this integration can help the people through entrepreneurship, through startups, through innovations, and finally as Abhay is dreaming, कि इससे पेटेंट्स कैसे आ सकते हैं जो दुनिया के लिए अपन एग्जांपल बन सकते हो सर, हम आपको सुनना चाहेंगे सर पहले.
सो नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. मेरे सहयोगी डॉक्टर पुनिया जी, श्री एबी शुक्ला जी, डॉक्टर अभय जेरे जी, दीपन साहू जी, डॉक्टर राजीव जी, और यहाँ इकट्ठे हुए हमारे सारे फैकल्टी मेंबर्स और स्टूडेंट्स जो इस वेबिनार में पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं, कुछ लोग डायरेक्ट हैं तो कुछ लोग यूट्यूब के जरिए हमारे साथ जुड़े हुए हैं. आज एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण विषय पर चर्चा करने के लिए हम इकट्ठा हुए हैं, दैट इज अबाउट द रोल ऑफ इंडियन नॉलेज सिस्टम्स इन व्हाट दे हैव डन और व्हाट वी हैड डन इन द पास्ट, एक्सप्लोर दैट इन टर्म्स ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड हेल्थ. बट उसके पहले, जैसे अभय जेरे जी ने कहा और पुनिया जी ने कहा, तो थोड़ा स्टेपिंग बैक, आई वुड लाइक टू गिव द जेनेसिस ऑफ दिस इंडियन नॉलेज सिस्टम्स. 18 मार्च 2020 को, यानी हमारी पैंडेमिक का लॉकडाउन शुरू होने के जस्ट 10 दिन करीब करीब पहले, हमारे मंत्री ने, उन्होंने एक मीटिंग बुलाई थी और वी ऑल मेट इन द MHRD. It was a marathon meeting. We invited 60 people. Our minister had given me the task of inviting people from all IITs, IISc, NITERS, NITs, Indian Institute of Science. All the institutions where something or the other is happening in Indian traditional knowledge systems, including Sanskrit universities and general universities. And within 2 days, the time given by the Honorable Minister was 2 days. So we were in a position to collate about 60 to 70 members, round them, half of them were present physically in the MHRD, remaining people were available on web from the respective institutions, and that meeting, which many people had felt that it will start at 2:30, means about 4:30 with a cup of tea it will be over. But when we started, Mantriji was sitting all through and it went on up to 8:30. So the seriousness of this was visible. Some of the participants were raising, earlier also sometimes such meetings are held and then we decide something and nothing comes in action. And therefore we have our serious doubts about what will happen in the future. But the very fact that Honorable Minister did not go for even for 1 minute outside, and that gave a strong signal that we mean business. And that is how in that very particular meeting a decision was taken that we will start a division called as Indian Knowledge Systems, or in Hindi called Bharatiya Dhyana Parampara, and that division will be established in MHRD, but it will be operated from AICTE, because we have both in terms of finances, in terms of space, some space is available, so it will be operated from here. But that was the decision on 18th March, minutes came, we discussed about it. This framework was prepared by AICTE, submitted to the ministry, it was approved, we created posts,
And we advertised the post after taking approval of the executive committee and council. We advertised and then shortlisted, conducted the interview, and now we have two people already on board. Sri Shuklaji and Nachiket Deshpande, two of the remaining three people are in the pipeline. We expect them to join anytime in the next few days. So that is the story. So now, what is the role of this particular division? Why should we start a division of such a kind? The main reason is we have all been fed by a Macaulay-based British education system where we have forgotten our past. First, in terms of all variety of knowledge, you talk about any knowledge which today exists, it has its roots in the ancient Indian science and technology as well as in various forms of art, craft, design, music, dance. So 64 kalas, you know, for 64 different types of arts, which are not even known to some of these people today, they were already existing. In terms of physics, whether it is Kannada, in terms of chemistry, Nagarjuna, in terms of maths, Aryabhatta, Bhaskara, then many others, including Brahmagupta, several rishis had done that research and given this in the form of shlokas, Vedas, Puranas, and it's a knowledge which is almost infinite. In fact, zero and infinity both are also given by India. We know zero and we know infinity also. All of the world knew about decimal system. We have the decimal system in place. So I think whether it is mathematics, physics, chemistry, material science, we are extremely well. But if you look at our textbooks right from class 1 to even our highest education, nowhere any mention of this is there, and we imagine, think that everything in science, technology and human development, and today people talk about human development index and they show that India is poor. Human development index was at its zenith in India. That is why it was called Sone Ki Chidiya, you know. And therefore, all the philosophies which the Western world today talks about has its roots in Indian ancient knowledge systems. Therefore, a division of that kind and getting on board all the things that were there in the past into our books so that we become inspired, we get motivated, we know about our culture, our heritage, and feel once again proud about it, but not just proud about it, but how all that knowledge is relevant even today. How it can be applied, how it can be applied, and how whatever research was done in the past, research is always growing. Research never stops. So what Newton did, Einstein undid a little bit. Someone else will come with a gravitational theory and then unification of forces, and whatever was spoken earlier in physics will also get vanished. But our wisdom was both extrinsic and intrinsic. And those philosophies in ancient traditional knowledge system, we have Sri Shuklaji, who is a scholar in Sanskrit, scholar in science. He will certainly be dealing with all of this. Now I'm going to connect few dots which have started off. You know, probably there was no design, but you know, things happen because sometimes they have to happen. And so, for example, Abhay Jere came to AICT and said that we should hold a Smart India Hackathon. And then we went to the then Minister Javadekarji, and then we started off. Now it is 4 years, we are continuing. We are channelizing the energies of the youth students in constructive work in solving problems of the society. See, this is one idea and which started off. Prime Minister himself had given a call for Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, how we can double the income of the farmers, how technology, science that we learn in our universities and colleges can be put to use for the development of villages, that migration from villages to cities does not take place. And in fact, the life in villages should be so robust and good that people should travel from cities to the villages back. I think probably we were still not doing it or not successful, but Corona that made it successful. Many of them who were staying in cities had to go back to the villages, and now we have to find out how can we employ them, how can we really make them do what they can do, and for that also we have to do under Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. So there is one side MIC, then there is Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, and meanwhile Indian knowledge systems came. So yes, ek taraf se hamara जो प्रयागराज में त्रिवेणी संगम है वैसे त्रिवेणी संगम है और वो त्रिवेणी संगम के घाट में AICT खड़ा है और हमको पीछे से ऊपर से मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन का समर्थन है, तो ये सब चीजों के साथ हम जब आगे बढ़ रहे हैं तो मेरे ख्याल से आई एम श्योर इन द इयर्स टू कम, इन जस्ट नॉट मोर देन 2 to 3 years, देर विल बी विजिबल इम्पैक्ट इन टर्म्स ऑफ द इन अ वे कल्चरल रेवोल्यूशन, इन अ वे साइंटिफिक रेवोल्यूशन, इन अ वे द नेशंस रेवोल्यूशन, एंड व्हाट आवर प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफन टॉक्स अबाउट यंग इंडिया, न्यू इंडिया, उसका चेहरा मुझे आज यहाँ दिखाई दे रहा है। तो वो न्यू इंडिया यंग जनरेशन का जो टैलेंट है उसको उपयोग करने के लिए जो चीजें चाहिए वो सारा जैसे मोल्ड बनता है ना, ये फाउंड्री में मोल्ड मोल्ड करते हैं, वो मोल्ड हैज बीन कास्ट, नाउ इट हैज टू बी हीटेड एंड इट हैज टू बी इन टर्न मेटल टू बी पोर्ड एंड वी विल गेट द कास्टिंग एंड दैट कास्टिंग विल डू वंडरफुल थिंग्स। जब मैं कास्टिंग की बात कर रहा हूँ तो हमारे एंशियंट ट्रेडिशनल नॉलेज सिस्टम में आयरन का हो, जिंक का हो, कॉपर का हो, उपयोग कैसे करते वो भी था। लेकिन आज का जो विषय है वो महत्वपूर्ण इसलिए है कि हम एग्रीकल्चर की बात कर रहे हैं और मेडिसिन या हेल्थ केयर की बात कर रहे हैं, ये दोनों बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण दोनों तरफ से है। जो आत्मनिर्भर भारत की बात कर रहे हैं, टू मेक आत्मनिर्भर भारत आवर विलेजेस हैव टू बी आत्मनिर्भर, इंडिविजुअल्स हैव टू बी आत्मनिर्भर, एंड फॉर दैट एग्रीकल्चर इज द बेसिस। आज भी हमारे यहाँ जो मैक्सिमम एम्प्लॉयड पीपल है दे आर इन एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर, मे बी द जीडीपी कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन मे नॉट बी एज मच बट certainly one which gives employment, one which gives food to the masses, one which will engage people and without negativity moving towards positivity. I think that is what our farmers do. They are our annadata, aur annadata ke liye agriculture is important. Aur humne jo bhi development kiya hai uske bare mein hum abhi zyada baat nahi karenge, lekin humko ye dhyan mein aa raha hai ki jis agriculture se humne productivity to badha di लेकिन सॉइल की फर्टिलिटी कम कर दी, और जो एंशिएंट एग्रीकल्चरल सिस्टम था जिसमें नेचुरली सॉइल का फर्टिलिटी कम न होते हुए प्रोडक्शन सिर भी होते हुए लोगों को अच्छी खाद मिलना ये सब हो रहा था, तो दैट इज व्हाट वी ऑफन कॉल सस्टेनेबल एग्रीकल्चर, वी कॉल इको फ्रेंडली एग्रीकल्चर, वी कॉल नेचुरल एग्रीकल्चर विदाउट यूजिंग इंसेक्टिसाइड्स और द फर्टिलाइजर्स विच इज ऑल नेचुरल फर्टिलाइजर्स फ्रॉम बायोमास and fertilizer, sorry, the insecticides in terms of whether neem or something like that. I think that was our agriculture, which was absolutely sustainable for thousands of years. And the new agriculture, which increased productivity, within a matter of 50 years, we are seeing the downturn actually. And therefore, sustainability in agriculture from the ancient wisdom is to be understood and brought back. And iske liye, mere khayal se Shukla ji humko aur bhi jankari denge. हमारे यहाँ मेडिकल सिस्टम आज यूनाइटेड नेशंस भी बोलता है सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स फॉर ऑल वैरायटी 17 गोल्स, बट उससे ज्यादा है मेडिकल हेल्थ केयर के बारे में जब चिंता होती है, जो कोविड के टाइम में हमको समझ में आया कि आवर सिस्टम ऑफ प्रिवेंटिव हेल्थ केयर, सी एक्चुअली मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज रोग होने के बाद उसका समाधान करना एक बात है, लेकिन वो रोग होना ही नहीं चाहिए, इसके लिए प्रिवेंटिव जो है वो हमारे देश में हल्दी है, नीम है और अनेक जो जिंजर है इसको लेकर जो हमारी इम्यूनिटी बढ़ाने वाला जो मेडिकल साइंस था जो हमको हमारे पूर्वजों ने दिया था, वेदर इट इज चरका इन चरक संहिता और इवन सर्जरी बाय सुश्रुता, ये सब नॉलेज हमारे से बाहर गया और बाहर से अंदर आता है तो हमको लगता है सब बाहर से ही निर्माण हो रहा है, तो ये जो बदल हमारे देश में लाना चाहिए उसके लिए हमको संस्कृत की भी पढ़ाई करनी चाहिए, योगा है, योगा का भी योगदान है, लैंग्वेज का योगदान है, आप जिसमें देखो उसमें योगदान किया हुआ है। तो मेरे ख्याल से आज का एक एक सैंपल है, ये तो ट्रेलर है, मूवी अभी बाकी है, ऐसे कहते मैं मेरे चार शब्द समाप्त करता हूँ और मैं प्लेटफॉर्म अभी श्री शुक्ला जी को सौंपता हूँ और उनसे ज्ञान संवर्धन करने में हमको मदद होगी, ऐसे कहते हुए मेरे चार शब्द को समाप्त करता हूँ।
Thank you, Chairman sir. I just would like to inform all my guests here that we currently have 3,200 people joining live for this session. They are listening live to the session. So I wish to congratulate and thank all of the viewers from various institutes. There is a lot of comments also, very positive comments are getting uploaded side by side. Deepan is monitoring those comments. Deepan, we can also request some viewers to post some questions, and if there is time at the end of the session, we can take few questions also, provided there is time. Now I request Shukla ji to start his address.
Sahasbuddha ji, Punya ji, Rajiv ji, and once again Abhay Jerry ji. And my pranam to all my young listeners. You might be surprised at this address. So I will start with a little story. Gautam Buddha, in his previous birth, before he became Buddha, he went to meet a person jinko already Buddha mil chuka tha. Buddha unke paas gaye, unko pranam kiya aur chalne lage. Wo aadmi utha aur Buddha ko roka aur baka dandavat karke pranam kiya. Everybody was surprised कि एक आदमी इसको बुद्धत्व मिल चुका है, उस इस एक बच्चे को प्रणाम कर रहा है, कोई दंडवत किस लिए? तो उस व्यक्ति ने जिसको बुद्धत्व मिल चुका था हंसकर कहा कि मैं इसमें आने वाला बुद्ध देख रहा हूं, उस आने वाले बुद्ध को प्रणाम कर रहा हूं, इसलिए आज जो यंग बच्चे हमारे साथ जुड़े हुए हैं मैं उनको प्रणाम कर रहा हूं कि उनके अंदर आने वाला साइंटिस्ट, आने वाला कर्णधार और आने वाला कर्मयोगी देख रहा हूं, इसलिए मेरा प्रणाम उन सभी बच्चों को जो आज इस प्रोग्राम से जुड़े हुए। दूसरी बात अभी उठी कोरोना की, दैट कोरोना हैज ब्रॉट अ लॉट ऑफ चेंजेस इन आवर लाइफ, बट आई विल से सो फार एज इंडियन नॉलेज सिस्टम इज कंसर्न्ड, दिस कोरोना हैज बीन लिटिल बिट ऑफ हेल्प आल्सो। माय यंग लिसनर्स माइट बी अवेयर दैट नाउडेज इन द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड certain things have become very common, like turmeric latte, turmeric pancake, golden milk, ginger ale. These things were not appreciated earlier, but all of a sudden, because this corona, the entire Western world, they are used to this thing. And what are these things? Nothing but India mein hota tha ki chot lag gayi hai, haldi mein doodh dal ke pi lo. That haldi mein doodh has become turmeric latte, turmeric pancake, turmeric tonic, similarly ginger ale. What is this ginger ale? Nothing but using our own traditional adrak, ginger, in such a way that it boosts your immunity. And because of these things only, I am reminded of one more thing, Giloy tablets. Very popular nowadays. Earlier, who thought about Giloy? Indian common creeper available in all the villages. Nobody thought of this Giloy. But today, it's very common, very popular. All of a sudden, much in demand. So these things have brought to the focus our Indian knowledge system. And I'm also reminded of one thing. In 1994, somebody in America got this turmeric patented under US patent law. Government of India had to struggle a lot. CSIR had to put a lot of data to prove that turmeric is nothing but our traditional knowledge. And ultimately, in 1997, I think, it was withdrawn, revoked. Similarly, somebody in 97, sorry, turmeric was patented in 95. And government did approved it is traditional healing system. So in 95 it was withdrawn. Similar, neem was patented in 97. And government of India had to struggle a lot, and until 2000 it was revoked. Similarly, Basmati rice, our Indian traditional thing, got patented. Again, for 6 years we had to struggle a lot, and ultimately got it revoked. Based on that, government of India was forced to create traditional knowledge digital library, TKDL. Now this TKDL has started collecting all this traditional data which could be misused otherwise by foreign countries, and that data is now available on digital form for everybody that we have been doing all this. Now since my young friends will be going to villages, I am told, so I would like to tell them what is the basic difference between city life and the village life.
and what they're supposed to go and learn from a village. What can they find out? The basic quality of village life is they try to live with the nature, as per the directions of nature. In this context, I would like to narrate three different incidents. I've been posted to Andamans, Arunachal, and I've been continuously, regularly visiting my own village. One thing common I've seen, that in a remote village, in a remote forest area where they travel, live in Andamans or in Arunachal, their fire is always kept intact, never allowed to extinguish. They've got their own traditional style. So they do not require any matchbox. Rely on their own traditional system, and even if there are heavy rains, their fire shall still be there. In what manner? And now you see, Andamans is 2,000 kilometers away in the sea, deep sea, and Arunachal, another part of the Indian continent. There is no connection, but for the last 2,000, 3,000 years, in the same style, they have been maintaining their fire. How? There was some Indian traditional knowledge available to all, and that has been preserved till date, without any connection with each other. That means they have been trying to understand nature properly. Something which we living in the city are forgetting. I can narrate one more story about the Andamans. You might be remembering, in 2004 there was tsunami. Now in Andamans, there are 7 tribes. Out of those 7 tribes, 3 are very prominent. Jarwas, Nicobaris, and Sindhanese. Nicobaris have learned Hindi, English. They have started wearing pants, shirts, so they are having common like all of us. They have started serving government of India also. So doing their service, living in modern style. But Jarwas, they don't mix up much. But at times they do come out and go back. But Sindhanese do not allow anybody come near their island. In 2004, I remember, while I was posted there, on a mission we went to Sindhanese island. And we were told that Sindhanese will not allow you to go come near the island. But they shall accept the gift taken by us. And they are very fond of red color. So we had taken some cloth of red color, some other items which they can consume, and went in a ship. And we are surprised when we are just 400 meters away from the island, all of a sudden, all Sindhanese appeared, armed with bow and arrow, and they warned, stop there only. We waved and showed them the gifts, the cloth, etc. They again waved, a boat may come and throw the items, but don't come near. We took those items, showed to them, and threw the sea. And they are such a fast swimmer. We are throwing like this, and immediately they were grabbing and taking back. And after all the gift items were taken by them, they started saying, go back. So they did not even allow us go beyond 400 meters to the island to see this thing. So they are totally cut off from the mainland, totally cut off from the outside world. So when tsunami came, there were 30 feet high wave that swept across Central Island. So we were thinking the entire Central would have been dead by now. But we are shocked to know they all survived despite a 30 feet high wave sweeping the island across. None of the Jarwas died. And unfortunately, Nicobaris died in thousands. How? That point has to be properly understood to understand nature. What happened when tsunami came? At least 2 to 3 hours before, the elephants, they sent something special. And they started running toward upwards the hill. Sab ke sab pahad ke chadne lage. Haathiyo chadte ekha, to kutto ne bhi dhona shuru kiya unke piche piche. Dogs also followed them. It was followed by cats. And Jarwas, who live deep inside forest, they also started running upwards the hill. And they all survived. Nicobari didn't do any such thing. So what happens when the tsunami is about to come? Sea will recede about 300, 400 meters backwards. And you stay there for about 5, 10 minutes. And then again come the full force. So Nicobaris, along with other, what should I say, well-educated mainlanders posted there, they all came on the seashore to see what is this strange phenomenon. And when again the next wave came, they were all swept away and they died in thousands. Now see the third stage of Sentinelese. They have no such signal from elephants or dogs or cats. But despite that, the moment sea started receding backwards, they took their children in their arms and climbed the trees upwards. 40 feet, 45 feet high, without knowing anything, no information, no knowledge, and despite that, all of them climbed the trees and all survived. Because they found out nature doing something extraordinary. And this extraordinary thing has to be treated in an extraordinary manner. So, what is the message from the nature? Jarvas, who were not having any informant from common man, they relied on elephants, cats, dogs, and survived. Centrally relied only on the behavior of sea, survived. Nicobaris, well-educated, become quite learned men, with all sort of modern amenities and exposure to modern world, they could not. So what Indian villager does, he relies on nature, and because of that, he is helped by nature. Now, a name was said here, Rishi Bharadwaj. I think Chairman Sir said that, I think Rajiv Kumar said Bharadwaj. Rishi Bharadwaj's name was not Bharadwaj originally, name was something different. But he was the one Rishi who invented the system of cultivation, preservation of seeds, and how ultimately that grains could be properly given different shape and made eatable. Because that only his name became Bharadwaj. Bharadwaj, he had created the anna and how to preserve that anna and how to use it, that anna. So he became Bharadwaj. So all the traditional system available in villages today are invented by Rishi Bharadwaj. And our villagers have been traditionally rely on that only. Problem has come, as Mr. Sahadudhay said, where we have started relying on other techniques. As long as we are relying on the nature, we are very happy. I am reminded of another story. And once what happened in a remote village of Arunachal, bordering Tibet, a British officer along his entire entourage went to inspect the village. There, because of mosquitoes, one of his colleagues got malaria. When he came back, immediately he said, no, no, we have to do something about the mosquitoes here. The village headman, he said, sorry, sir, let us live as we are living. Don't interfere. He said, no, 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 this cannot be allowed. You cannot rely on nature for malaria. Otherwise, malaria shall spread and you should all be infected. He said, sir, you are outsiders. We rely on our smoke system, other system. That's why we are not getting infected. You are outsiders. You didn't live in our style. That's why you got malaria. Kindly do not interfere our life. Somehow, he didn't agree and he got some thing spread in the entire village. And within no time, hello, I think video of Mr. Jere, is it still working or not? Mr. Jere?
It's no, working, sir.
Please continue. Working. I'm not seeing the video here. Everything's coming off. Am I still audible?
Yes,
absolutely.
Okay. So, what happened thereafter? The mosquitoes are gone. Village was free from malaria as per what British thought that time. But after some time, they realized all the cats were also gone. They died. And after some time, the rats started mutating and there was plague in the entire village. The same British officer again went to village. You know, we have brought some medicine for the plague. This time, the headman said, come what may, we shall not allow it to interfere with our life. Please go away. They went to other villages and borrowed certain cats. Brought cats, rats were eliminated or controlled rather. And intact, okay. Then the village headman said, look, sir, in nature, everything has got its own utility. We cannot disturb anything. You remove one thing, it ought to have effect on other things. So please, please do not interfere with our life and our nature. We totally rely on nature. And nature has got utility even for a butterfly, a mosquito, a chameleon, a snake. Everybody has got a role to play and we go with that only. Please, no more interference henceforth. And then surprisingly, he quoted one mantra from our Shukraniti. Of course, he must have given Tibetan translation, but I can quote the exact mantra. Say, Amantram Aksharam Nasti. There is no letter which cannot be used as a mantra. If you do not know it, it's your fault. Nasti Moolam Anoshadham. There is no root of any herb, tree, plant, or shrub which cannot be used as a medicine. If you do not know, it's your fault. Ayogya Purusho Nasti. And there is nobody who is incompetent. Yojaka Tata Durlabha. We don't have good managers, otherwise everything can be made to work. Yes, sir. Nature has got utility for everybody and for everything. Let us go with the nature. So with these words, the British officer had no choice but to leave them. And they are still happily. I have been to that village while I was posted on Machal. Just for my academic interest, I went there and saw that. Okay, that's correct. They are still very happily and totally relying on nature. Even now, they prefer not to use our modern gadgets. Mobiles have reached there, but they don't rely on that. And beautifully, if anything is to be conveyed, even the top of the hill, through their drums and other signals, they convey the message. We were there at the bottom, going to the top of the hill. He said, sir, go there, you shall be getting tea ready. I said, how? He said, we have sent message. He said, there is no more, nothing. He said, no, sir, we have sent message. And what they have done, by making certain sounds, through a drum. The message was there that so many persons coming and tea should be ready. And when he reached that village, tea was ready there. So that is their system. So we have to think on those lines how to go there and how to find out and live with that. Now, these young students, when they are going to villages, they have to learn this. In what manner the villagers are living that life? They have since thousand years understood nature and its beauty. That's why our all the festivals, they are season-based. Coming Navaratra, Sharadi Navaratra means now summer is over, winter is going to start. And normally they keep fast because they are making their body ready for the next season. Then Basanti Navaratra, again now the winter is over, summer is about to come. Again they fast and prepare themselves for the next season. And now not only this, their food also, that is also as per the dictates of nature. So that has to be learned with from them. They make Deepavali. What is Deepavali again? Light the lamps, do all set festivities because now winter has come, set in. Come Holi, they shall play with the water and colors. So now summer is come. South Indian Pongal, change of season and getting ready for that. Similarly, our all the temples, they used to have a pond nearby. What was that? That was system for the rainwater harvesting. Those who belong to Gujarat, they go see the Rani Ki Vav. Beautifully planted. Entire area dry, but that used to remain full of water. How? They had made system that water step by step coming and was being collected Rani Ki Vav. So those were our systems in villages to make rainwater harvesting, preserve water, and make sure water table is there, it is not going down. And as the chairman sir said, they used to depend heavily on turmeric, neem, basil, tulsi patti, ginger, and garlic. whenever there is any problem, what they used to do? Body pain is there. Boil garlic in mustard oil and do little massage. Your rheumatic pain is over. This is not available to our cities, but villages, they immediately all the pains gone. Turmeric, I've already discussed. Any cut, any wound, any pain inside, milk with turmeric, it's gone. Similarly, for ladies to have fresh food without adulteration, what was there? Wheat grinding, curd churning, paddy crushing. So lady used to do all this. So there was no need to go to gym, which our ladies need to go now. At the same time, unadulterated fresh food was available. Of course, this we cannot bring to our cities. Our ladies cannot do it. But at least we can understand that in what manner we have to do some physical exercise to maintain our mental and physical health both. And by doing that, we can always ensure that as per nature we are going ahead. And now another field of agriculture. There was a traditional system of seed collection and its preservation. Nowadays we have got cold storage, and despite that, the seed quality is somehow deteriorates. It's not that good now as it was earlier. How? Their system was for collection and preservation almost foolproof. We have forgotten that. Similarly, they had got this management of cattle system. Firstly, the local cattle, they used to be reared and given proper protection. But with the introduction of American cows, even that system is gone. So beauty with the Indian cow, Indian system is missing. The Athari Samhita, that describes a lot in what manner this farming, preservation of cattle, preservation of seed was done. That needs to be brought back and told to our farmers who are doing farming with the modern style that these are the traditional systems given as per the Athari Samhita. Similarly, our Rig Veda that talks a lot about fertilizers, and that fertilizer produces organic grains. In the absence of that fertilizer, the fertilizer which we are using, as Mr. Sahasbuddha said, is spoiling your land. After two or three yields, quality goes down. Whereas with that fertilizer, it was never going down, continuously going up. So that system needs to be again revived. And people have been told about that, in what manner we can ourselves make fertilizer, use it properly, and go ahead. One more thing which I remember just now. In villages, without any meteorological system, they understand now is a time for heavy rain or mild rain or no rain. There is a common saying, Aage Mangal Piche Bhan, Varsha Hogi O Saman. If that combination is there, this year it's going to be scanty rain. But on the contrary, if they see that ants have taken the rakes and they are climbing the walls or trees or kites, they are coming down and playing in the air at a height of 400 meters, like swimming in the air like this, they know that it is going to rain immediately in a rainy season. And in case not rainy season, the temperature is going to come down substantially. So by seeing kites, in what manner they are reacting, acting in the sky, they used to know that season is going to change, temperature is going to come down. And in case it's in rainy season, they used to know it's going to rain. But in case ants have started going upwards with their eggs, they used to know now it's going to rain fast, 7 to 10 days continuously. So immediately make arrangement, take things inside, preserve it, otherwise left out, it will be spoiled. Another point was, Now we don't find much sparrow in the cities because of the vibrations, because of pollutions and other things. Even the villages, sparrows are very few number, rarely seen. But those days, sparrows were found in abundance. And beauty with the sparrows was, whenever it was going to rain very heavily, 14, 15 continuously, it will come down and start playing with the dust. When the villagers used to see, now sparrows have come and they are playing with the dust, enjoying it, throwing dust here and there. They used to know now it's going to rain continuously. And immediately they used to make arrangement for that. So we have to understand these things from a villager. But my dear students, in case you go like this only and try to extract knowledge, you cannot. My suggestion, my advice is go as Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita. How you can acquire knowledge? He says, Tat vidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya updekshanti te jnanam jnanina tato darshina. So there are five components. First, he says, you see a man who is jnani and tato darshi. That means the person with whom you are going to interact, he is not having any bookish knowledge. He has experienced it. Tattvadarshi, that he has seen it, he knows it. Once you find that man, then you are supposed to take knowledge from him. In what manner? That also he explains. He says, Tattvavidhi, isko jaan lo. Why? Three steps. Pranipatena, Pariprasnena and Sevaya. Firstly, I shall explain Pariprasnena. Prasna, teen prakar ka hota hai. Prasna, Ati Prasna and Pariprasna. Prasna means sadhan si baat hai, iska uttar koi bhi de sakta hai, jiske liye aapko aadmi ko kisi kuch identify karne ki zarurat nahi hai, then that is Prasna. Aapne pucha ye bus kahan jati hai, ye rasta kahan jata hai, anybody can answer to that. It is called as Prasna. Lekin, jab aap Prasna isa puchte hai, iska uttar koi de na paaye, then it is known as Ati Prasna. जैसे कि गार्गी ने पूछा याज्ञवल्क्य से इस ब्रह्मांड को किसने बनाया तो उन्होंने कहा गार्गी अब तुम अति प्रश्न पूछने जा रही हो कि अगला सवाल मैं कहूंगा ब्रह्म ने बनाया तो तुम कहोगे ब्रह्म को किसने बनाया दैट मींस नाउ यू डोंट वांट टू हैव आंसर यू वांट टू एम्बैरस मी तो जब कभी भी आप किसी आदमी को एम्बैरस करने की कोशिश करते हैं कि इसका उत्तर दे ना पाए दैट इज नोन एज अति प्रश्न बट वॉट इज परिप्रश्न जब पूरे मन की सरलता से पूरी श्रद्धा से आप प्रश्न पूछते हैं उत्तर पाने के लिए उसको समझने के लिए तो उसको कहते हैं परिप्रश्न तो कृष्ण कहते हैं कि आप गांव में जाएं आप देखें कोई विलेजर है डोंट थिंक मैं सिटी का वेल एजुकेटेड बॉय हूं व्हाई शुड आई शो एनी रिस्पेक्ट टू हिम एंड आस्क द क्वेश्चन अगर ऐसा नहीं करेंगे तो आपका अति प्रश्न होगा परिप्रश्न नहीं होगा और अगर परिप्रश्न नहीं होगा तो आपको उत्तर भी नहीं मिलेगा That is one. First is pranipaten. Pranipaten ka real meaning hai dandavat karna, pranam karna. Lekin yahan par Krishna kehte hain dandavat nahi. Kyunki agar dandavat karne se gyan milta hota to Bhishma Pitama kabhi nahi milta. To Bhishma Pitama bhagwan Krishna ko dandavat karte the. Sorry, Krishna Bhishma dandavat karte the aur Bhishma unko Ayushman Bhav kehte the. To tatpar yahan par dandavat karne se nahi hai. तात्पर्य है मन के श्रद्धा और समर्पण से कि श्रद्धावान लभते ज्ञान अगर मन में श्रद्धा नहीं है समर्पण नहीं है तो आपको ज्ञान कभी नहीं मिलेगा तो अगर किसी गांव वाले से मिल रहे हैं उसे पूछने जा रहे हैं तो आपके मन में उसके प्रति पूरी श्रद्धा और पूरा समर्पण होना चाहिए अगर पूरा श्रद्धा और समर्पण है और उसके बाद में आपने परिप्रश्न किया फिर क्या होगा उपदेक्षण तिथि ज्ञानम फिर जो भी बोलना शुरू करेगा वो आपके लिए उपदेश बन जाएगा और आपके काम आएगा तो मेरी आपको एडवाइस है कि जब आप गांव जाएं किसी भी ज्ञानी से मिले और जिसके बारे में आपको पूरा विश्वास हो जाए इस व्यक्ति ने इस चीज को अनुभव किया है इस लाइफ को उसने स्वयं जिया है इसने वर्षा के बारे में इसने हेल्थ सेक्टर के बारे में जो कह रहा है जिससे आप गाँव जाएंगे देखेंगे कि कोई चोट लग गई है कान में दर्द हो रहा है वो आदमी जाएगा एक पौधा तोड़ेगा उसको यूं मसलेगा उसके कान में रस डाले ठीक हो जाएगा अब आप में से पूछना होगा बाबा ये कौन सा पौधा था और कैसे डालते हैं, इसको कैसे पहचानते हैं। अगर आपने पूरी श्रद्धा से बात करते हुए, परिप्रश्न करते हुए और सेवा मीन्स टू गेट कनेक्टेड, आप उसके एक संबंध स्थापित कर लिया तो बता दें बच्चा ये ऐसा पौधा होता है और इसको डालने से कान का दर्द ठीक होगा, ये दूसरा पौधा है इसको लगाने से पैर का दर्द ठीक होगा, आपके सर में दर्द है इसको माथे लगाओ ठीक हो जाएगा। इस प्रकार इतने गाँव में छोटे छोटे पौधे अवेलेबल हैं जिनके माध्यम से वो इलाज करते हैं, वो आपको बताएगा। लेकिन वो बड़ा आदमी तभी बताएगा जब आप इन तीन कंडीशन पूरा करेंगे, प्रणिपातेन परिप्रश्नेन सेव्या। इन शब्दों के साथ में मैं आपको शुभकामना देता हूं कि जब भी आप जाएं गांव तो अपने इस मिशन में सफल हों और लौट के आकर के इंडियन नॉलेज सिस्टम को वो ज्ञान दें जिसकी हमें आवश्यकता है, हम उसको रिकॉर्ड कर सकें और रिकॉर्ड करके सर्कुलेट कर सकें बाकी सभी के लिए। कि अभी कुछ लोग जाएंगे, मैं चाहूंगा इस ज्ञान को जो आप लाते हैं इसको प्रॉपरली रिकॉर्ड करके हम लोग सभी को सर्कुलेट करें ताकि सब तक पहुंचे। आपने ध्यान से सुना, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, नमस्कार।
थैंक यू वेरी मच शुक्ला साहब, वंडरफुल प्रेजेंटेशन एंड मेनी ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस आर आल्सो देयर फ्रॉम स्टूडेंट साइड। द कनेक्ट व्हिच यू एस्टेब्लिश, फर्स्ट मैसेज व्हिच यू आर गिविंग, बी कनेक्टेड विद नेचर, नेवर अवॉइड नेचर, नेवर गो अगेंस्ट नेचर, दैट इज फर्स्ट मैसेज। Second one, respect of the people. Even people may not be having that much education, but the experience and values which they are having, please respect those values. In fact, and it is a strong message for our Indian students. And new education policy is saying that our students should be connected with the whole society. They should feel responsible that we people are meant for the betterment of the society. And it is basically the dream of this new education policy in our agriculture system, sir. The way you have presented why our agriculture system was very special, and particularly Rishi Bharadwaj, the way preservation of seeds, the message which he has given, the method it has been devised without any cold chain mechanism or without any strong technological base of that preservation, nothing was there. 7000 years back, sir, we were having strong cotton belt in Kashmir. And the way the cotton was being grown, the way the seeds were being preserved was amazing. Some 5,000 years back, southern part of the country, particularly the region which you are saying it is Tamil Nadu now, they were very, very strong in rice. At present, in this part of the country, northern part of the country, around Delhi, if you see, there are 100 varieties of mangoes in whole world. If you collect all together, there may not be 100 varieties. Around Delhi, in 100 kilometers, there are 100 varieties of mangoes. Country is having some 750 varieties of rice now, 750 total variety. In artisans, contribution of artisans, if you see, the iron pillar, as Chairman Sir was saying, in iron, in metals, even in zinc, the way our artisans were dominating, there is no example, parallel example for that one. In Delhi, we are having iron pillar. 1,000 years back, our artisans, they manufactured this one. Even today, we don't know what was the mechanism. It was foundry, it was means casting, or it was forging or welding. We don't know what mechanism. The first form of iron we were having in Karnataka, one place, it is Kollar. In Kollar, around 700 years back, Adi Shankaracharya ji came. And in respect of Adi Shankaracharya ji's, gaon ke logon ne ek iron pillar banaya. Wo itna bada pillar to nahi hai, chota hai. But even after 700 years, in that region, around 750 centimeters of rainfall is there. There is no sign of deterioration on that iron pillar. आपने जो जिंक की बात की सर, the melting of zinc since last 5000 years, India is dominating. Just around I think 500 years back, China has started. Otherwise, we were dominating. The biggest challenge in zinc smelting it is. Its melting point is 999 degrees Celsius and its vaporization temperature is 1000 degrees Celsius. There is only 1 degree Celsius difference between liquid phase and vapor phase. Even it was very difficult to collect those vapors. Our Indian artisans, in place of heating that furnace from bottom side, they were heating from top side, and vapors were going down due to density and those vapors were being collected. These artisans were strong because our farmers were strong. These artisans were helping our farmers, because on this earth, if some first letter someone has written, it is by Indians. If some farming activities it has been started, it was by Indians, and those artisans were helping our farmers. So connect of farmers and artisans was very, very strong. Farmers were just like industry. Artisans were just like academic institutes. Wherever problems to the farmers were there in innovation, those artisans used to help them. Any sort of equipment, appliances which farmers were needing, those were given by our artisans, in fact. So the industry was the farmers and academic institutes were our artisans. There was a strong connect between artisans and our farmers. Some questions it has been asked by students, sir, and probably honorable chairman sir will be giving answer of that one. One question it has been asked, sir, shall we put agriculture as a mandatory subject in engineering? क्या एग्रीकल्चर का सब्जेक्ट हमारे मैंडेटरी होना चाहिए? एग्रीकल्चर के बिना कोई बेस नहीं है. कंट्री इज हैविंग 70% पॉपुलेशन बेस्ड ऑन दिस एग्रीकल्चर. इन आवर जीडीपी नाउ इन टफ टाइम व्हेन जीडीपी वाज गोइंग डाउन सम 20% नेगेटिव ग्रोथ वाज देयर दैट टाइम एग्रीकल्चर वाज एबल टू सस्टेन. इट मींस दोज पीपल आर समथिंग वेरी वेरी स्पेशल. व्हाट एग्जैक्टली दे आर डूइंग, हाउ दे आर मेंटेनिंग दिस जीडीपी? क्या सर वो जीडीपी का मॉडल, वो जो मेंटेन करने का मॉडल उनका किसान का है, क्या छात्र भी उसको कॉपी करे? हु आर दी फ्यूचर? आपने कहा गौतम बुद्ध जी ने जो है प्रणाम किया, नतमस्तक होकर प्रणाम किया विद्यार्थी का, कि आप जो है मैं आगे का बुद्ध आप में देख रहा हूं, आपकी भावी पीढ़ियां जो है भावी बुद्ध आप में है. इन द सेम फैशन दीज टैलेंटेड बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स विच वी आर हैविंग इन द कंट्री, उनकी रेस्पेक्ट करना जो है ये भी हमारे शिक्षकों की जिम्मेवारी है. और ये पूछ रहे हैं कि सर एग्रीकल्चर को क्यों नहीं एक सब्जेक्ट जो है आप इंजीनियरिंग में जोड़ने साथ में, सो दैट वी कैन कंट्रीब्यूट फॉर द बेटरमेंट ऑफ फार्मर्स फॉर द विलेजेस.
पुनिया जी समय खत्म हो रहा है तो इसलिए क्विकली आई वुड लाइक टू आंसर. नंबर वन, नया एजुकेशन पॉलिसी में राइट फ्रॉम स्कूल एजुकेशन लॉट ऑफ स्किल सेट्स आर ब्रॉट इन. सो वेदर इट इज गार्डनिंग, एग्रीकल्चर शुड स्टार्ट ऑफ फ्रॉम द एज ऑफ सम 9 or 10, दैट मींस अराउंड द क्लास 6th ऑनवर्ड्स. So naturally, one who has earned some of the skill sets of agriculture and plants, etc., from 6th standard to 12th standard, when they come to college, those who are interested will certainly be allowed, should be allowed to take agriculture as one of the topics, maybe as an elective, because we are talking about multidisciplinary universities. Institutions should have possibility of taking courses other than their own domain as well. And therefore, rather than making it compulsory, those who have got interest, those who come from agricultural families, those who have got land holdings, if they learn that agriculture, they should go and practice that back home. I think that should be the spirit. Just forcibly making everyone study everything may not be feasible because the number of credits available are limited. But anyone who is interested should get an opportunity to study agriculture. The base and foundation or the seed is already or should be sown when they are in the high school. Aap bol rahe the rice ki variety. Actually, there are seeds which are 3 lakh variety of rice seeds are available in our storage. India has that. Philippines and other countries are also having 75,000 varieties of rice seeds. I think one of my friends who is an advisor to the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, K.V. Raju, has narrated how much of wealth of seeds and their preservation system exists in our country. So I think we must go back and look at what is all possible, what is all available, and should make use of this. As far as the other aspects are concerned, there are multiple things. Sir Shukla ji ne bataya ki tribal society mein aur bahut bahut interior mein unke paas aise herbal medicines hai. I have also witnessed in somewhere in Jorhat, in Assam, in village, a person, lady, she is having a herbal solution for whenever you have fracture of bones, you apply it for 2-3 days and then your bones will get joined. And whatever we do, plastering and all that by the medical doctors is done by a tribal woman. I think these kind of techniques which are available, जैसे शुक्ला जी ने कहा, हम जब गांव में जाएंगे उनके साथ दोस्ती कर रहे हैं, उनको नमन कर रहे हैं, उनसे प्रार्थना कर रहे हैं कि हम सीखने के लिए आए, हम आपको सिखाने के लिए आए करके गर्व दिखाएंगे तो कुछ भी आपको मिलेगा नहीं. तो ये बहुत ही अच्छा शुक्ला जी ने बताया, वो फॉर्मूला हम यदि यूज करेंगे तो वेदर हमारा उन्नत भारत अभियान हो या हमारा जो इनोवेशन काउंसिल है उसके जरिए भी जो एम्बेसडर्स है ये सब लोग जब गांव में जाएंगे तो उस दृष्टि से जाएंगे तो मेरे ख्याल से बहुत ज्ञान का संवर्धन हमारे पास हो जाएगा एंड दैट नॉलेज वी कैन शेयर विद द रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड।
अति सुंदर सर, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका। एक और छोटा सा क्वेश्चन आदरणीय शुक्ला साहब से है। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्टूडेंट्स आर एप्रिशिएटिंग द वे इट हैज बीन प्रेजेंटेड, दे आर वेरी हैप्पी। इन फैक्ट दिस क्वेश्चन व्हिच हैज बीन आस्क्ड सर शुक्ला साहब, हाउ आईएएस कैन बी यूज्ड एज ए टूल टू प्रमोट एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप अमंग द स्टूडेंट्स सो दैट दे कैन कम अप विद इनोवेटिव वेंचर्स फॉर फ्यूचर इंडिया एंड वर्ल्ड।
दिस फिर से रिपीट कर सकते हैं, आई कुडंट हियर प्रॉपर्ली।
The question is, sir, how IKS can be used for the strengthening the entrepreneurship in time to come for our country as well as for whole globe?
ये तो बड़ा ही अच्छा प्रश्न है और relevant भी है। हमने अब जैसे पहले कहा कि मैं चाहूंगा कि जो भी IKS में पहले नॉलेज इकट्ठी करेंगे और इस प्रकार की नॉलेज से फर्टिलाइजर वाले मत कहिए, अगर हम ऑर्गेनिक तरीके का बनाया हुआ फर्टिलाइजर जो सॉइल को खराब नहीं करेगा इसको डेवलप करते हैं, ये अपने आप में एंटरप्रेन्योर्स के बहुत बड़ा काम हो जाएगा। इसी तरीके सीड प्रिजर्वेशन का है, अगर ट्रेडिशनल तरीके सीड प्रिजर्वेशन का हम तरीका बनाते हैं गांव गांव में तो वहीं पे बजाय आदमी कोल्ड स्टोर लेके जाए, सिमिलरली ये जूसी फ्रूट्स होते हैं इनका पल्प ट्रेडिशनल तरीके से बनाया जाता है, ट्रेडिशनल तरीके से, और वो इससे बढ़िया होता है जो हमारा प्रिजर्वेटिव डाल बनाते हैं। मैंने गाँव में देखा है आम का है और चीज का जो पल्प बनता है उसको बहुत तरीके से सुखा कर बना लेते हैं वो विदाउट प्रिजर्वेटिव एंड दैट लास्ट टाइम। तो इस तरीके बड़े सारे ऐसे काम हैं जो गांव में रहकर के ट्रेडिशनल नॉलेज से सीखे जा सकते हैं, डेवलप किया जाता है। केन के बारे में है, गांव में केन होता है उसके फर्नीचर बन सकता है और उसको मास स्केल बना के भेजा सकता है, केन भी अवेलेबल है, मैन पावर अवेलेबल है, जरूरत है उसको सिस्टमेटिक तरीके से ब्यूटीफाई करके बनाने की, वो नहीं हो रहा है। इसी तरीके से IKS के अंदर इतने आइटम निकलेंगे भी, अभी मैंने कुछ ही इसमें काउंट किए हैं, बट वंस वी स्टार्ट डूइंग प्रॉपरली उसको इकट्ठा करना शुरू करेंगे, जॉट डाउन करेंगे, वी शैल हैव एटलीस्ट 100 सच वर्क्स व्हिच कैन बी डन लोकली यूजिंग इंडियन नॉलेज एंड दे कैन गिव गुड रिजल्ट्स।
वेरी गुड सर, सो मेनी 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 अपॉर्चुनिटीज विल बी देयर इन टाइम टू कम इफ यू आर एबल टू कनेक्ट आवर इंडियन नॉलेज सिस्टम एंड 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 द नॉलेज व्हिच स्टूडेंट्स आर कैरिंग। वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम अभय जेरे, अभय वन स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम असम, ही इज आस्किंग इन आवर रीजन पर्टिकुलरली फार्मर्स आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम फ्लड्स एंड वी वुड लाइक टू कनेक्ट आवर सेल्फ, वी वुड लाइक टू हेल्प आवर फार्मर्स, हाउ आवर टेक्नोलॉजीज कैन हेल्प इन अवर्टिंग दीज फ्लड्स एंड इवन इफ फ्लड इज देयर हाउ वी कैन हेल्प देम, इन व्हाट वे द फार्मर्स कैन बी हेल्प बाय द टेक्नोलॉजिकल नो हाउ।
So, sir, this is again a very good question. And as we are rightly saying, we have to promote innovation and entrepreneurship across all the educational institutes in that region. As you rightly said, sir, flooding is a huge problem in northeast states, including as well as states like Bihar. And what we believe is that, sir, we need to have innovative ways of actually predicting the recurrence of the flood as well as sir, the quantum of damages which might happen, which can actually result in the damages, sir, because that prediction is sometimes really missing and people are taken aback with the scale of what actually happens. So, sir, if we can come up with right kind of technologies of predicting based on, so what we should do is actually collect data, look at the earlier data, do ML, AI kind of a modeling on top of it and get into a predicting model so that we will able to give right kind of interventions based on those predictions. So that's where I believe that data analytics will have
a huge value. Abhay, we are saying some prediction mechanism, it has to be devised that can predict in advance and that can help the farmers. One question, sir, again from Shukla sahab, that ancient agriculture methods in the era of global warming, how they can help in reducing the global warming, our ancient methods of agriculture.
That's what I started from. I say the Indian trade system, they maintain the ecological balance. I just said by their own system, the rain harvesting system was inbuilt. Similarly, the everything was inbuilt, traditionally made house. It remains warm the winter and cold the summer. In cities, what we do? We use more ACs, more heat. More heat, more ACs. More ACs, again more heat. So that way we are disturbing entire global warming system. Whereas if we go back to villages, everything is so natural that it reduces the global warming. All the traditional systems and more this inbuilt rain harvest system that also maintains our water table. Water table is maintained, rains are on time, and then more trees are grown. So that way the balance is automatically being maintained. By forgetting the Indian knowledge system, we are drifting away from that and inviting the global warming. That's my response.
Thank you very much, sir. Can you explain in 2 minutes how your portal is working, how your ITS portal is working, and can this portal help to our students also? Rajivji, aap kuch kehna chahenge?
Yes, sir. Sir, what I could get from Shuklaji's speech is that we should connect from the nature. And what in the villages, when I was young, and as in the village, in my village, my mother and my grandmother, they used to talk to birds, they used to talk to crow, they used to talk to animals we have in our house. So we never said ki ye meri gaay hai. Meri gaay ka ek naam hota tha, aur us naam se hum usko bulate the, to wo gaay aa jati thi. So this was the connect between the human and the animals, whether they are birds or cow or etc. एक बार सर मैं गांव में जा रहा था, एक गांव में था, गांव में शुक्ला जी ने बहुत सारे प्रसंग दिए, मैं नेचर की एक बात बता रहा हूँ सर, एक पौधा होता है जिसका बॉडी से लगने से खुजली शुरू हो जाती है तो वो मेरी बॉडी से लग गया, तो मेरे साथ वहां लोकल साथ के पुरुष थे, उन्होंने दूसरा पौधा उसी पास से उगाड़ा और मेरे वहां पर रगड़ दिया, तो उन्होंने ये बताया कि जहां पर ये पौधा होगा उसका सोल्यूशन उसी के साथ होगा. दिस इज हाउ अवर नेचर इज बिल्ट. और मैं आपके पास सर, पुनिया सर, आपके साथ तो बहुत डिस्कशन होता है इस बारे में, गांव में जैसे हम देखते थे, आपने नेचर में बताया कि हम आकर ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग की बात करते हैं, हमारे गांव में क्या सिस्टम था, एक सर पता नहीं हमारे जो मेरठ का इलाका था उसमें कूड़ी बोलते थे सर, जिसमें हम पूरा अपना कूड़ा जो होता था पूरा उस पर लाकर इकट्ठा करते थे, बिक्री गाय का गोबर भी होता था और घर से निकला हुआ या झाड़ू का कूड़ा सब उस पर डालते थे, और उसको डालने के बाद हर हफ्ते हम गांव में उसको अपने खेत पे ले जाके डाल देते थे, तो ऑर्गेनिक खाद पूरे साल की इतनी तैयार हो जाती थी और उसको फिर फसल आने से पहले, बोने से पहले हम खेतों में डाल देते थे. ये जीरो वेस्ट सिस्टम था, जो वेस्ट होती थी इसी वेस्ट से हम खाद बना के खेतों में डाल देते थे, और ये हमारा एक सिस्टम चलता रहता था. गाँव में बड़ा सुखद जीवन था, कभी किसी ने ये बात नहीं की इस नल का पानी मत पियो ये खराब होगा और इस नल का पानी अच्छा होगा. हम लोग खेतों में चलते हुए जो पानी ट्यूबवेल से आता था वो पानी ऐसे उठा ऐसे पीते थे सर. दिस टाइम ये तो मैंने अपने आप जिया है. आज जब बिस्लरी का पानी पीते हैं, ऑफिस में पीते हैं या बाहर पीते हैं, तो वो जब समय याद करते हैं तो समझ में आता है कि हमने क्या पाया है और क्या खोया है. और आदरणीय शुक्ला जी, आप सब जब बोल रहे थे तो ये लगता कि आप रुके ना, ये खुद से बता रहा हूँ. और सर जब आप रुके तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा नहीं लगा कि आप क्यों आपके जो प्रसंग थे सर वो दिल को छुए, पता नहीं पुराने टाइम में ले गए, अपने से कनेक्ट किया, अपने में आप झांकने लगे. हम सर बहुत सही कहा, और आपने जिस तरीके का ज्ञान हमें, आपने जो इस तरीके की सोच AICT इस संकल्प से आपने ITS सिस्टम को जिस तरीके से आगे ले जाने का जो आपकी विचारधारा है, सोच है, सब उसके लिए हम आपको प्रणाम करते हैं, सत प्रणाम करते हैं. और जो भी AICT की तरफ से और मिनिस्ट्री की तरफ से और हमारे पर्सनल तरीके से होगा सर, हम हृदय से आपके साथ हैं. ये ऑफिशियल कोई वर्ड नहीं है सर, ये दिल से जुड़ने वाली बात है, और ये काम केवल दिल से निर्णय हो सकता है. इन्हीं शब्दों के सर नमस्कार, आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू राजीव जी. जब भी जगे तभी सवेरा, जब भी अगर जग जाए, और नहीं तो ये एक कोरोना वायरस नहीं, देर में भी थाउजेंड्स ऑफ कोरोना वायरस, दे विल बी स्पॉइलिंग, दे वोंट अलाउ वी पीपल टू रन लाइक दिस वन. ऐसी दौड़ने नहीं देगा नेचर, अपने को रुकना पड़ेगा, अपने को नेचर की तरफ देखना पड़ेगा. इन 2 मिनट्स बुद्धा जी, यू प्लीज टेल अस हाउ योर ITS पोर्टल इज वर्किंग एंड इन व्हाट वे इट कैन कनेक्ट अवर टीचर्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स.
हां हां, यस सर, सॉरी, आई वाज इन अनदर मीटिंग.
प्लीज.
Sir, thank you for giving time. So this is a wonderful opportunity. I see that as a technologist, you know, I'm getting an opportunity to work on a kind of a project which is going to have the preservation of all our traditional, natural and cultural wealth of our country. So that's where, you know, I strongly feel that I'm very lucky to be in this project. And then I started doing lots of study on the technology side, on the mathematics, logistics, linguistic, Akshara Laksha, what is that? You know, I never know when I did my engineering or MBA, but I'm lucky enough, you know, I learned all this in the science of architecture, constructions. I mean, even the cooking, the Supa Sastra, I was amazed that we used to have 3,032 varieties of dishes. So I learned all this different technologies, traditional knowledge, and then we started creating this Indian Knowledge Systems website. So in that website, basically it has multiple areas. I mean, one is we are publishing the traditional knowledge. The second one is we are publishing the ongoing traditional knowledge projects, based projects on different segments. So we have created a portal where the existing researchers or the people who are interested in Indian traditional knowledge can register themselves on the portal. So that's one block. Then once we receive that information, we validate all that information. And after validation, we are publishing those publications as well as projects on the portal. And the thought process here is to create a knowledge repository for not only for Indians, for the entire world, because this is the right area we need to fill in the gap of Vishwaguru. So this can be not only for Indians, this can be accessed by anyone in the world. So we are validating the information and publishing the information.
Very good. Very good. Deepan, now we are concluding. Say a few words of extending sincere thanks to everyone, particularly Shukla Saab and Honorable Chairman Sir.
Thank you, Punya sir. Actually, it is really a wonderful session, and I got the information that more than 4,000 students and faculties, they are watching us, they are listening us, they are giving their feedbacks, they are appreciating also, and they are appreciating that how agriculture, and they will contribute back to the society in terms of bringing the traditional knowledge. And also we have circulated the link, the IKS portal link, and they are willing to participate, willing to submit their things, and they will get another 1 week to two weeks time to submit their research, prior research areas, and also the knowledge they will get scouted from the village area after interaction with the farmers and the villagers. So definitely this knowledge base is going to help us in further refining their thought process, and also creating the knowledge repository and bringing, adding to the knowledge library of Indian knowledge system. And the wonderful session given by our Honorable Chairman Sir, Anil Sahasrabude Sir, and giving that the philosophy behind this IKS, and with the vision the Ministry of Education has started this department, and our Sri A.B. Shukla Sir has given the expert talk on giving a very examples, very lively examples, and also people, all of our students, they are able to connect with their regular daily practice, and definitely they will go with this kind of learnings back to the society, and they will try to scout these ideas, and they will submit in our IKS portal. So thank you Shukla sir, and thank you Punya sir for the highlighting the MEP provisions and how this agriculture, health and other traditional things are now amalgamated and also now joined with the modern practice, and how to enrich that Indian knowledge system. And thank you to our member secretary sir, Professor Rajiv Kumar sir, for giving the example of his childhood time, and how we are still connect, how we can connect with the nature, and how we will get derive the peace and the satisfaction from the nature, and by staying connected with the nature. So it's a very well connected way, very lucid way, very beautiful way all experts have delivered. And thank you to Abhay Jane sir for giving the brief overview about the various initiatives of our MIC cell, and how our our IIC institutions, those are watching us and those are part of this network, are going to benefit from all this wide variety of systems and the support systems created by AICT, Ministry of Education, Ministry of Education Innovation Cell, and Budhaji for explaining that IKS portal and how it is going to capture in a very simple format. And also I will thanks to my all my colleagues, IIC team, Pankaj Pandey, Ankush Sharma, Selva Rani, Sunny, and Udyan, and all the members, Ajay Sadashiv, and all my assistant innovation director and the director of MIC for putting this, creating this vibrant IIC network and connecting with the IIC institution and helping this system to grow in a very organic way. So thanks to all the members for joining and watching this session, and thanks all the experts for distributing and passing their knowledge to the all our audience. So it is a wonderful session. Again, thank you to all.
Very good, Deepan. Thank you to all. Very good. Namaste.